I'd really like to get something going here. This is something very different. I've got 10 questions. I'd like to get some video responses to this. I'm going to answer them first, okay? Okay, these are 10 questions for Christians, okay? Question number one, how old were you when you were first saved?
11 or 46. Let's see, October 8th, 1996, so I wasn't 46 till the 25th, so I was 45. As if you go by, there's this, what's Red Smokey calling? Some kind of a controller. He's got that word he uses all the time for yoke up. He says, oh, that's when I was saved. I thought I was saved at 11, but I can go with his definition. And he says he's not in the doctrine. But it's a theological dispute we have. And I can go with it. In fact, I was going with it before he asked me again. And I said, well, I used to think it was 11. This is going to be a long time, huh? 10 or 20? 10 questions. It won't be that bad. 10. I can't think of that word that he's called, though. A controller? Yeah, a controller. Did I say that first time? Don't ask me too many. No more than 10 questions. Okay, go ahead. 11 and 45.
Question number 2. Who led you to Jesus Christ?
We call him Candyman. He's a short black dude in the New Orleans Mission. He was a resident. He's a dead ringer for Sammy Davis Jr. He didn't want to hear that. I don't know his real name. That was at the 45. At the 11, it was a vacation Bible school. Guy's name was Danny. He was like a teenager or a young adult, like in his early 20s. Took me and about 10 other kids about the age of Javit. That's when he got saved at 11. So then, you know, I think about that. Because then for the rest of my life, I did what I wanted, kind of like what Javit does.
Question number 3. Have you ever led anyone to Jesus Christ?
Yeah, we'll leave it right there.
Question number 4. Which is your favorite book in the Old Testament?
I don't have a favorite book in the Old Testament. I've never heard that. Yeah, I guess. Next question.
Question number 5. Which is your favorite book in the New Testament?
You know, truthfully, I was inclined to say Mark first, and that's wrong, because I feel that was written to the Roman soldiers, is how I look at it. Matthew's written to the Jews, right? And Luke wrote to the intelligentsia in Greece, and John wrote to the believers, and that's my favorite gospel. I don't want to go crazy here. I think you ought to read Acts next. You're saved. Who am I talking about? What do you know about Revelation?
6. Where do you want to be in your walk in 20 years' time?
Above ground.
Number 7. What frustrates you most in your walk?
The thorn in my side. And the fact I can't accept it, and I know I'm not better than Paul. And then I received a thorn, and I'm grateful for the thorn in my side, just like Paul has one. And then my frustration turns into the fact, why was I frustrated with a thorn in the side, and I become grateful for it. See, I'm not the kind of guy to ask these kind of questions.
Which person from Scripture do you most associate yourself with?
I never associated myself much with one particular person. Maybe in praise and worship, King David, when he was praising and worship in the forest. But other than that, I really don't have one. I want to have an answer for that, but I don't have one. Thinking ahead, and riding on a white horse next to Jesus. That's me. I don't know who that guy was. Nobody did that in the Bible, right? So I don't really have a person in the Bible I associate myself with. All right? Man, sorry. You don't expect to get answers to all these questions, right? Just because you got all the answers doesn't mean we're going to have all the answers.
Question number 9. Does the thought of dying bother you?
No. No. It never did. Even when I was lost as a goose at midnight in a snowstorm, it never bothered me. I'm just that kind of person. And now, you know, now that I'm saved, man, does it not bother me. You know. Okay.
Describe a supernatural experience you've had with God.
No. Oh, I won't answer that question. Been on the internet since 2003, and I've been on a couple of video sharing sites, and I'm just not in the mood. I do enough to create enough heat for myself without talking about supernatural experiences with God. I'll tell you something though. When I was unsaved, like in that period between 11 and 45, I did pray to get out of lockdown one time. I got on my knees. I had a bunk-style bed, and I spoke Jesus' name into a prayer. I said, Jesus, I want to get out of your bed. And a judge, to the surprise of the guards, the staff, whatever you want to call them, was brought in, and I was in a court hearing inside the institution. So that's enough right there. And I had free flight out of the state into another state. The judge arranged that. I mean, this judge he came out of anywhere. He didn't come out of nowhere. He came from a courthouse inside. I'm telling you what, I got home. I was married at the time. My wife says, what are you doing here? And I looked at her, what? She was so shocked. She says, how did you get out? I said, I prayed to Jesus. Well, boy, that drove her crazy because she was into something different than that. She was into New Age and tarot card reading, and I almost blew apart the marriage. I tell you, it changed it forever. Well, I'm not married to her now. So that's me not talking about supernatural experiences.
Okay, so I'm just asking that you, that other people respond to these 10 questions, post a video response. I'd love to see them. God bless.
God bless you.